obviously the big driver these days. It's pushing a lot of people out of work, and even the people who do have work are, you know, what they sometimes call underemployed, right? I assume all of you are close to or sympathetic to that position.
Yes.
Right? Real unemployment rate. So, but we have to look, you know, even though we have a good turnout here, we have to consider the fact that we can be, we still need to do what? We need to expand, right? We have the majority on our side in theory. We say it, right?
Yep.
But we need to make sure we actually get the majority on our side, right? We need to do things in such a way that people feel like they want to join us, right? So we have to kind of conduct ourselves in such a way that working people, the working class, whatever that is, we have to define it, right? I mean, who is the working class? You know, it's not like it is 100 years ago. It's not like it's factories, right? The service sector is the working class. People think of manufacturing as the working class. Manufacturing jobs are 10 million jobs. The service sector is 115 million jobs. 10 times bigger. You know, so we have to think about things like this in terms of who is our base? Who can we recruit? How do we expand? You know, are stockbrokers going to be part of the base?
No, probably not.
Right? You might get some nutty eccentric stockbroker. There's always going to be exceptions, right? You know, there's probably a stockbroker in the back. Like, I'm with you. Paid off some bridge. Revenge for that guy. But, like, you get the idea, right? So when we build, we can do it slowly. We don't have to do this, you know, overnight, right? We have time on our side. We have the ability to go out and think in such a way that allows us to expand. Right? Does that make sense?
Yep. Yeah. Yep.
All right. Good. Well, that's my opening speech. I think I'm just going to leave it there.
The next thing we'd like to do